13 NIV version. Amen. Micah chapter 2, verse 13. The one who breaks open the way will go up before them. They will break through the gate and go out. Their king will pass through before them, the Lord at their head. God, this is your time, your moment, your space. I'm your tool. These are your people. One more time today, Lord. I need your strength.
Yes.
I need your power. Help me preach. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I want to talk this morning as a spiritual guide. Amen. Following the leader. Following the leader. Amen. If you don't mind, turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Amen.
Let's follow, the leader.
The leader.
Wow. Amen.
I tell you, I can remember like it was yesterday when I was a boy, growing up in the projects of Owen Center. Me and my childhood friends, we played a game. It was called Following the Leader. In the game, someone had to be identified as the leader. Someone had to be chosen. And whoever was chosen, everyone else would line up behind the leader. Then the leader would move around however he decided, and the other boys would have to mimic the leader's actions. That's why they call it following the leader. Any of the boys of the players who fail to follow or do what the leader did was put out of the game. Some of you probably played follow the leader as well. If you would allow your mind to just run back, you would probably say, you know what, I know what you're saying, Pastor Preacher. I did some crazy things following the leader. And if some of you told truth this morning, amen, some of you are still doing some crazy things following some leader. Some could testify this morning, I wish I had failed to follow a particular leader at a certain point in time in my life. If I wouldn't have played follow the leader, I probably would be in the condition that I'm in this very moment.
Amen.
If I wouldn't have followed an individual that wasn't going anywhere, I would probably be somewhere. Okay, I'm going to get up off of that. Amen. In our text, we have the prophet Micah, who is speaking the heart and mind of God. Amen. And he's declaring judgment upon Samaria and Jerusalem because of their sins. Amen. The prophet declares that the judge was coming. He was referring to God, beloved. Somebody say, God is coming. God, beloved, was angry because of the widespread sin of idolatry, covetousness, and abuses, beloved, that was running rampant among the people. And I don't care who you think you are. I don't care who you actually are, beloved. There is something in your life and in my life, beloved, God needs to deal with.
Yeah.
There are some things in our lives, beloved, that is keeping God from breaking out in our lives. There are some things, it don't get kind of quiet in here right about now, but there are some things in our lives that is keeping God from being really who he is. There are some things, there are some people that are serving, they are coming in between what God really wants to do in us and through us, beloved. And I know when you look in the mirror, I know you see someone perfect. I know you see someone that got it all together. I know you see someone that has it going on, but beloved, if the truth be told, there is something in each one of our lives that we are all dealing with. I don't know what it is for you, but you got something, amen? You don't know. Some of y'all wonder, what's wrong with the rebel? Ain't nothing wrong with me. I got some stuff I'm dealing with just like you. Got some stuff you dealing with, amen? And God is angry because God wants to do something in the lives of the people, but there is idolatry, there is covetousness, and abuses that is running rampant among the people. Beloved, as much as we would love to remove ourselves from this particular group, we can't. Somebody say we can't.
We can't.
No, we can't do it. There is no question that we all fall within the list of this list of pre-salvation. Because before we were saved, there was some stuff that was wrong with us. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
But I'm talking about post-salvation. Now, I'm talking about since we have met the Lord. I'm talking about since we have claimed Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. There is still some stuff going on in our lives. I don't care how well you can shout. I don't care how well dance. I don't care how well you can preach. I don't care how you can make the instruments sing. But there is something that is going on in your life that God wants to deal with. And then God is ready for all of us to break out of something. Can I get a witness? It ain't just about you breaking out and getting you a car. You breaking out and you give you a house, and you break it out, and you give you a bunch of money. No, God wants to break you out of some mess. God wants to break you out of some foolishness. God wants to break you out of some relationship so you can begin to walk in your purpose, walk in your destiny.
Yes, amen.
Glory, Jesus. Yeah, yes. Even after the sacrifice of Jesus, many still suffer intentionally from idolatry. Y'all know we'll cover some stuff, won't we? Y'all know we'll abuse some stuff, won't we?
Come on now.
Vices. We all did some pretty ugly things in our past.
Yeah.
We can look back and remember some of us were pretty messed up.
Yes. Come on now.
Yeah. God's honest truth can't hide. We got to own it.
Yes, that's right.
It's amazing how church folk try to deny. Deny our stuff.
Come on.
Deny where the Lord brought us from. Act like we've been clean all our lives. No, we've been pretty dirty. Thank God for the blood. Thank God for Jesus. Loving us in spite of our sin.
Thank you, Lord.
Romans 2:5-6 says, but because of stubbornness. And your unrepentant heart, you are storing up wrath for yourself. In the day of wrath, when God's righteousness and judgment is revealed. But because of Jesus, we didn't get what we were owed. You're welcome. Because of Jesus, we've been redeemed. We've been recovered. We've been reclaimed, brought back. We've been purchased by the blood. Somebody done been delivered. Somebody done been brought up out of prison. Emancipated, liberated, loose. Somebody has been released and set free. Saved and rescued by the blood of Jesus. Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. He met us when we were messed up. But Jesus came into our lives and changed the whole course of everything in our lives. You can say that he came into our lives abruptly and changed our lives. He changed our thinking. Thank God for his only begotten son, Jesus. That's why every now and again you ought to just call his name. You don't need no special reason to say Jesus. You can't tell on the job, just bring out with Jesus. Situation ain't right in the home, just spread out Jesus. It's something about the name of Jesus. And while you out here looking for a quick fix, just shout Jesus. Jesus, he came in and he did something about our situation. Now, some of you may be confused about what I'm talking about. Some of you may not have a clue of what I'm talking about. You may not have any areas in your life where you need to improve or where you need God to break out something. You know, I do realize, in my naiveness, I do realize that we still have folk like that in the church. Yes. Folk who don't need no help. Yes. Folk that got it all together. Yes. Folk, they come and they listen to the music and soon after the preacher get up, they tune out because they got it all together. Yes. They've been around long enough. I don't need you telling me nothing else. Yes. I do realize that we got no kind of folk in the church, the ones who have been inclined to, they don't even consider spiritual assessment anymore. Think about my walk. I don't have to think about my walk. I walk like I want to walk. I talk like I want to talk. I do what I want to do. No. This ain't for you. This ain't for you. Anytime the word makes you a little uncomfortable, you shut the preacher down. Like the preacher been looking in your window. I ain't got time to look in your window. But it's okay. It's okay because the word is not for people with itching ears. It's for people with open ears. The word is not for people with a haughty heart. The word is for people with a contrite and open heart. And I'm going to talk to some folk this afternoon that know that there is another level available. Come on, tell your neighbor, there is another level that is available. There is another level of commitment. There is another level of service. There is another level of love and forgiveness. There is another level of community impact and involvement. There is another level of ministry. They call it the kingdom. Somebody say kingdom. See, many of us, we want to do ministry, but we don't want to do kingdom ministry. See, some of us want to do lazy ministry. Some of us want to do ministry when I feel like it. Some of us want to do ministry when I got time. But no, there is another level. And beloved, if you're going to experience your breakout season, and I do realize some of you really are ready for your breakout season. Beloved, you're going to have to learn to follow the leader. You see, I don't want you to get it twisted. I don't want you to think I'm talking about me. But I ain't talking about me. I'm talking about the leader with the capital A. I'm talking about the same one I'm trying to fall. I'm talking about the same one I'm looking at. See, some of y'all might have said, who he think he is? He beat him on up the fire again. No, follow the Lord. We've got three points we're going to get at. And the first point I want to share with you, as you follow the leader, you must be committed to go vertical. Please write these down, because I believe they'll bless you later on. You must be committed to go vertical. Can I work this 13th verse? First part of it says, the one who breaks open the way will go up before them. Too many folk has to come and maintain a horizontal attitude about everything in their life. Their home is horizontal. Their marriage is horizontal. Their job is horizontal. Children, church, health, finances, education is horizontal. But look, when you remain in a horizontal state, you will miss your breakout moment. When you are fixed on the horizontal, you can only see what the situation is and not what it can be. You can only see and feel the reality of the pain and the suffering that you're experiencing. But beloved, God wants to do something about that pain. God wants to do something about that situation. God wants to do something about your frustration. God wants to do something about the hurt. The people were broken and hurting, beloved, because of sin in their life. And God wanted to do something about it. God wanted to restore them. Somebody say restore.
Restore.
Now, if there ain't nobody in here this morning that don't need some kind of restoration, I'm in the wrong place. Because I believe there is somebody under the sound of my voice that is ready for God to do something in your life. But if you expect God to do something, beloved, you got to get vertical. You got to look up, beloved. You got to get your attitude up, beloved. You got to get your perspective up. You got to stop looking down. You got to stop hanging your head down. You got to get up, beloved, because it's up there when you find your help. That's when you find God. That's when you find your hope. That's when you find your peace. You find it looking up, not looking down. And if you want to see something different happen in your life, you got to go vertical. You got to get up off your do nothing. You got to get up out of the ditch. You got to come up out of that bad situation. And when you go up, you'll begin to see the situation different, beloved. Even Einstein said that you can never solve a problem on the same level that it was created. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I got to get vertical. I got to go higher. I got to get up out of this. God didn't create me to stay in this mess. I got to go higher. I got to elevate myself. I got to get up out of here. I got to get vertical. Tell your neighbor, neighbor. I might have came in a little down, but I'm about to go Lord's trying to get you to incline, but you stay right there. You done had the same attitude, had the same thought process, and talking about, Lord, help me. Lord, make a way out of no way. God said, won't you begin to think differently? Won't you begin to see yourself differently? Won't you begin to speak in life on your situation? Won't you get in your word? Won't you do something for somebody else? Won't you get married? See, let me tell you what the enemy wants you to do.
Come on, tell
him. See, the enemy wants you to stay. First of all, he wants you to go into God and then stay.
That's right. That's right.
See, this world around us like dumb stuff.
Yes.
Why do you think the ratings are so high for reality TV? Because, see, that's that God stuff. That's that stuff that's not of God. And see, they know. See, they know we'll be here on Sunday morning. Oh, God, is a great God. Where is it? But where's the night? Stay straight. the big lizard was on his tail. But when the small lizard, all of a sudden he shifted and went another direction. The big lizard fell off the wall. I don't know who I'm talking to, but you need to get ready to move. You need to get ready for what God is about to do. And when God gives you that moment, when God creates that opportunity, you better shift. Somebody say shift. Oh, I'm ready. God is about to do something in my life. I'm tired of being horizontal. I'm about to go vertical.
And move and have our being.
And when I do my own self-assessment of my life, now get your mind off me. Look in your own mirror. But when I realize and I assess my life, I realize that my sins, they warrant justice. I realize that I spent too much time wasting God's investment. I realize that the return on God's investment in me kept coming up short. I realize that I spent too much time only concerning myself with myself. Cleaning up, like after other folk, I'm cleaning you up, for where